Welcome you all in this video lecture series on chapter breaks. Up till now we have studied all theoretical and conceptual part regarding the break. Now hereafter we will start solving problems based on this break chapter. These problems we have divided into four parts. Firstly, we will see the problems on single block break. Then we will see problems on double block break. Third video we will see the problems on simple band break. And in the fourth video, we will see the problems on differential block break. So let us start with this first video on problems on break, that is problems on the single block break. So before starting to this, all theoretical part regarding this single block break or shoe break, you must know that you can study on the link given in the description box. So please watch that video first and then you come to solve these problems on single block or shoe break. Now in that we have seen the braking torque can be found for the single block break as Ft into R, whereas Ft is a tangential frictional force on that wheel, and that can be found by formula mu into Rn, and Rn is the normal reaction force between the block and wheel, and R is the radius of wheel that we have seen. So if you want to find out this braking torque, you must know how to calculate this Rn. And there are the two cases for this single block break, that is if the angle of contact between the block and wheel is less than 60 and if the angle is more than 60. So if it is angle less than 60, then the same formula Tb is equal to Ft into R or Tb is equal to mu into Rn into R can be used. But if that angle is more than 60 degree, then you have to use the formula for braking torque as Tb is equal to mu dash into Rn into R, whereas mu dash is the equivalent coefficient of friction, and that you can find out by the formula mu dash is equal to 4 mu sin theta divided by 2 theta into sin 2 theta. That is the only difference. If angle is less than 60, you have to use one formula, and if angle is more than 60 degree, you have to use some different formula, that is mu dash into Rn into R. Only mu dash is the extra thing you need to calculate. But basic formula in this chapter for solving the problems on single block break is braking torque is equal to frictional force into radius, that is Ft into R. So how to calculate that Ft? For that purpose, we have seen the three different cases while studying the theory part. And these three cases are based on the Ft, that is, where is that friction force lying? In case one, this theoretical part we have already seen in the first theory lecture. You can study that. Here just we will see the formulas regarding that. So in first case, that Ft is passing through the fulcrum point. In second case, that Ft is passing below the fulcrum point by distance A. In third case, that Ft, that is frictional force, is passing above the fulcrum point by distance A. In all these three cases, if you want to find out the Ft, then there are the two cases, that is when wheel is rotating in clockwise direction and when wheel is rotating in anticlockwise direction. You have seen that when wheel is rotating in clockwise direction, that Ft tangential force or frictional force is acting towards right hand side direction, and if those wheels are rotating in anticlockwise direction, that Ft frictional force will act in left hand side direction. So for all these three cases for clockwise direction, how to calculate the moment, that we will see. And after that, for all these three cases only, if wheel is rotating in anticlockwise direction, then we will see how to calculate the moment. These are important. Why? Because each case here, whatever we are studying, is in the problem only. So problem will be based on these cases only. In these cases, you need to find out the braking torques. To find braking torque, you have formula Ft into R. There, you need to calculate Ft, that is frictional force, Ft. And that you can calculate by taking the moment at fulcrum point O. So in first case, when rotor is rotating clockwise direction, how to calculate the moment, that you can see here, taking moment at fulcrum point. Ft is passing through the fulcrum point, that's why it will not be in the formula of moment. Therefore, moment at point O is equal to Rn into x, and the sign for that Rn into x moment is positive because it is rotating in anticlockwise direction about fulcrum O, whereas P force is acting in downward direction. That's why it will create a clockwise couple at point O. Therefore, the sign for that P into L will be negative, is equal to 0. Only two forces are there in that case 1. Therefore, Rn into x minus PL is equal to 0. This will be moment about fulcrum point O for this first case. This moment you need to calculate while solving problems also. Therefore, if you understand how to take the moment, it will be easier to calculate Ft or Rn easily. So in second problem, second case, taking moment about O, there will be Ft because Ft is below the fulcrum point by distance A. Therefore, it is acting in anticlockwise direction about point O. Therefore, in formula, it will have the sign positive. Rn into x, that is also having sign positive because it is also acting in upward direction and create an anticlockwise couple about point O. P force is downward, that's why it will create a clockwise couple about point O. Therefore, it is also having the sign negative. Next, for third case, taking moment about O, you can get the formula as Rn into x because it is positive couple, Ft into A, it is anticlockwise couple about point O, sorry, clockwise couple about O, therefore it is having negative sign. Next, P into L will be also creating one clockwise couple, that's why it is also having a sign negative. Like that, you have to calculate the couples, and after finding these couples, you have to find the you have to put the values in these formulas of couples, and you have to get the value of either Rn or Ft. And you have to put this value of Rn or Ft in the formula of breaking torque. Ft is equal to, sorry, Tb is equal to Ft into R, or Tb is equal to mu into Rn into R, and you will get the breaking torque. These are the formulas only. This is only one formula for Tb you require. Other, you have to take the moment at that time while solving problem only. Similarly, three cases, if rotor is rotating anticlockwise direction, in those cases, you have to take the moments similar way, whatever we have solved for the clockwise only, but just here signs will get changed, because see, in the first case, Ft is again passing through the fulcrum point, that's why Ft will not be there, formula will again become same. In second case, Ft is passing below the fulcrum point by distance A and create a clockwise couple, that's why it is having negative sign. In third case, Ft is passing above fulcrum point by distance A and it will create an anticlockwise couple, that's why it is having plus sign. It is the only difference between clockwise and anticlockwise rotation of wheel. After this, you have to find Rn or Ft that you have seen already, and you have to put these values in the formula of Tb, and you will get the braking torque Tb. One more thing to remember, if the brake is self-locking given in the problem, then in that case you have to consider that effort P is equal to zero. Self-locking condition, what is that? We have seen already in the theory chapter of brake. You can see that. Now, if self-locking is given in the problem, that means when you have taken the moment here, that for in that formula P into L is there, that value becomes zero because no effort is required to apply on the brake if brakes are self-locked. Remember this note. Now we will solve the first problem. If you know all this conceptual and theoretical part regarding the simple block brake, then you can solve the problem easily. Now we will read the problem. A single block brake is as shown in the figure. The diameter of the drum is 250 mm. Now diameter is given. From that diameter, immediately calculate radius, because in the formula we required radius of the drum, and it will be 125 mm. Convert it into meter also, because it is required further. And the angle of contact is 90 degree. Angle of contact here given is 90 degree, that means theta 2 theta is given as 90 degree, and if 2 theta is 90 degree, that means above 60 degree, you need to calculate equivalent coefficient of friction, that is mu dash, that will calculate further. But here 2 theta is equal to 90 degree, converted into radian also because it is required in the formula of mu dash. 90 degree is equal to pi by 2 radian. Next, in the problem, if the operating force of 700 Newton is applied at the end of the lever, that means force P applied in downward direction is 700 Newton, it is given, and the coefficient of friction between the drum and lining is 0.35, that means mu given in the problem is 0.35. Determine the torque that may be transmitted by the block brake. So you need to calculate the TB, that is braking torque. So before starting, you first find out the equivalent coefficient of friction, that is mu dash, by the formula 4 mu sine theta divided by 2 theta plus sine 2 theta, because the angle of contact is more than 60 degree. So by putting the values of mu as 0.35, theta as 45 degree, and if in numerator 2 theta, there you have to place the value of theta in terms of radian, and wherever sine theta is there, there you have to place the value of theta in terms of degrees, that is 45 degree. So after putting these values, you will get a mu dash value as 0.385. after finding that mu dash, you know the formula of TB, that is braking torque is equal to FT into R is equal to mu dash into Rn upon R. Either you find FT or find out Rn to get the TB. So for finding these things, you need to take the moment about point O. So by taking moment about O, look into that diagram. Rn force is in acting in upward direction. It will create an anticlockwise couple about point O. Therefore, Rn into distance is 200. It is positive because anticlockwise direction we have considered positive. For clockwise couple, we have considered as a negative sign convention. Next, FT into the distance between FT and O point is 50 mm. Therefore, FT into 50 will have the sign positive because it is creating clockwise couple about point O, minus 700, P into 450, because total distance between that P force, that is 700 force, and O is 200 plus 250, that is 450 into P. It is creating clockwise couple about O, that's why sign is negative. Now put the values of FT as mu dash into Rn. Now here we are converting the value of FT in terms of Rn, and we are finding the value of Rn, and after finding value of Rn, reaction force, we are putting it in the formula of TB is equal to mu dash into Rn into R. One can find, or one can put the value of Rn in terms of FT and find out FT and put the value of FT in the formula of TB, that is TB is equal to FT into R. You will get the value of TB easily. So it is your choice to convert this equation in terms of FT or in terms of Rn. Here in the first problem, I will convert this into in terms of Rn. And in second problem, we'll convert in terms of FT. So I will convert this equation in terms of Rn. Therefore, I will put here value of FT is equal to mu dash into Rn. Take the common value of Rn. Then find the value of Rn is equal to P into 450 divided by 200 minus mu dash into 50. Put the values of P as a 700, mu dash as a 0.385. We already find now. This value of Rn you will get as a 1742.73 Newton. This is the normal reaction force we have got. Put this now value of Rn in the formula of braking torque, and you will get TB is equal to mu dash into Rn into small r. You will get the value of TB as a 83.86 Newton meter. This will be our answer. So problems are very simple. Next problem we will see, second problem. Figure shows the brake shoe applied to drum by the lever AB. In that diagram, you can observe, generally diagrams are given in the problem. So by observing diagram also, you can write the given things. So here you can observe that radius of that drum is given as 160 mm, convert it into meter. Then the coefficient of friction of the brake lining is 0.3, that means mu is given, and if the drum rotates in clockwise direction, now here you can observe the direction of rotation of drum is given clockwise, that's why FT will be acting in the right hand side direction. It is also shown in the diagram. Find the braking torque due to horizontal force 600 Newton at B point. 600 Newton force is given, that means it is a P force given to you, and you need to find out the breaking torque TB. 2 theta angle here given in the diagram, not in the theory description of part of question. It is given in the diagram. Theta is 20, therefore 2 theta value is given as a 40. Therefore you can say that as the value of theta is less than 60, you need not to calculate here mu dash. In previous problem we have found the mu dash, here not necessary to find the mu dash value because theta, 2 theta angle is less than 60 degree. Now here distance between that FT and fulcrum point A, because fulcrum point or pivoting point is given in the problem is A, that A to FT distance you can find because A to center of that wheel distance is 200 minus radius of that wheel is 160 is equal to 40 mm will be the distance between FT and A point that is necessary in the further calculation. So next, we know the formula of breaking torque TB is equal to FT into R, or is equal to mu into Rn into R. So here we will find the FT by taking moment at point fulcrum point, and that fulcrum point is A here, not O. Just make that change. Here that fulcrum point is A, not O. So at A, if I take the moment, I will get summation of moments at point A is equal to Rn into distance between Rn and A point is 350. It is creating anticlockwise couple at A, that's why it is a positive sign. FT is creating again an anticlockwise couple at point A, and at FT into distance between these A and FT is 40, just now we have calculated, minus P into 750. Yes, 750 is 400 plus 350, P into 750. Now put the values of FT as mu dash into Rn, or put the value of Rn is equal to FT upon mu dash. In last problem, we have converted this equation of moment in terms of Rn. Now here we will convert this equation in terms of FT by putting the value of Rn is equal to FT upon mu dash and taking the common FT. You will get FT value as, by putting the values, you will get FT value as 372.8 newton. Now once you get FT value, put the value of FT in the breaking torque equation TB is equal to FT into R, you will get the breaking torque as 59.6 newton meter. So this will be your answer. Next problem. Now this is a very simple problem, again similar type of problem we have solved previously. A single block break is as shown in the figure, has a drum diameter of 250 mm. Convert this diameter in terms of radius. The angle of contact is 90 degree. Here angle of contact, that means 2 theta is given, is more than 60 degree. That's why you need to find out here mu dash value first. And the coefficient of friction between the drum and lining is 0.35 mu is given. If the operating force is 650 newton is applied at the end of the lever, that means P is given, determine the torque that may be transmitted by the block. Here, if the wheel is rotating in clockwise direction, your FT will be acting in right hand side direction that we have seen already. If FT is acting in right hand side direction, the value of this FT you need to find out, and you need to put the value of this FT in the breaking torque equation. This is the only thing. Solve this problem at home and write the answer in comment box. So thank you very much for listening, and if you are any doubt, put it in the comment box and subscribe to this channel. Thank you all.